Good morning.
Morning.
Thank you, Joyce. That was beautiful as usual. Surely appreciate Joyce. We do not appreciate it when she's gone. Oh, I am glad to be here. I am glad to see all your faces here. And we are getting closer and closer, I hope, to a time when we can see those smiles once again. Do we have Joyce? Chloe, hi, looky there, all right. We have, it is just so good to be here, and it is a joy to be on this beautiful day. Even though it's supposed to be windy, it's supposed to be warm, so it's going to be a good day. Are there joys? You have grandchildren back there. That's a joy.
Yes.
It's good to see you guys too.
Every Sunday we see one more face coming back.
I love it.
That we haven't seen for a year. Yeah. So it's good to see Mary's face back today. And just look forward when we can see everyone's face back. So, hallelujah.
Absolutely. I have a cute little short story. If you ever want to know what you do, and a minute ago I noticed myself going like this, talk among yourselves, I was telling, a month or so ago, I was telling Kristen something, and she was holding Easton. And the next thing I know, Easton is going, Thursday when I went to visit, I was telling Cody something. And it was a more involved story, but of course I'm using my hands, and there's little Hudson sitting there close to me, and he's going like this, and going like this. Okay. You want to see a mirror? Yeah. Anyway, lots of fun. I do enjoy it. I hope I don't do something bad if they repeat that. I try really hard. Any other joys?
We are here,
and that is always a very good thing. Concerns, of course, we want to keep Lori and her family in our prayers, especially on Tuesday. It will be a hard day. Not that it's not hard now, but it will be an extremely hard day. So we want to especially keep her in our prayers on Tuesday and all the family. Any other concerns? Besides all our normal things, sometimes there are too many to name out loud, but God knows what's in our hearts. Announcements. Council will meet this Thursday at 7 p.m. The reason for that is Naftal and his family are going to Washington, D.C. so they can get their papers instead of having to travel back to Mozambique. And he is going to be gone from the 15th through the 24th. So that is a good thing that they don't have to travel back, especially when they can't at this point. So that works out very well. Next Sunday will be daylight savings time, and I will have to set an alarm. I can guarantee you that. I will have to set an alarm. The insert in your bulletin, if you would, when on your way out the door, if you'd set that on the back table, then I can recycle those and then I can use them the next time. I think the last time I hadn't said anything, but I did manage to get some, so that way I don't have to print them every time. So that'd be great if you would do that. And our mission this month is for Haiti. They will be traveling if they can, If they can't, they will still be doing missions for Haiti, and Mary Lou sent out something for us for that. Is there anything else we need to lift up? If not, let's stand for our call to worship. O God of all ages and all generations, we come to worship you. Women, men, youth, and children bow before you, the only wise God. Our foreparents led the way for spiritual awareness and growth. We try to follow in their footsteps, recognizing you as God of all. As we worship you, all your attributes of glory, mercy, and love show forth. We humble ourselves in your holy presence because you are awesome. Holy, holy, holy is the name of the Lord. Amen. Our opening hymn is How Great Thou Art, 77.
Thank you. We come before you, Father Almighty. We give you thanks for this beautiful morning. We give you thanks for the gift of life. We give you thanks for bringing us to this place to worship you. Now, as we come together, we ask you to send down your Holy Spirit to guide us in everything we're going to do here. We have come here, O Lord, hungry and thirsty for your word and your righteousness. Feed us until we are satisfied. We are here, O Lord, seeking your peace, your love, your grace. Provide to us, O Lord. We trust in you. Father, we are here to worship you, and we have started worshiping you through our singing, through our prayers, and we will be worshiping you through the word which will be proclaimed, through our offerings, and through the sharing the table which is set before us, reminding us your love and your presence in our lives. In all these stages of our service, O Lord, we ask you to be there. We ask you to guide us. We ask your Spirit to show us the way and the best way to do things so that we may please you. Bless this congregation. Bless each and individual who was able to make to this place this morning. And bless those who are following the service virtually. All of us, we open our hearts, we bring our lives to you, seeking your blessings. You know what we bring in our hearts. You know the prayers we bring this morning to you. Father, in your love, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for those who won't be able to join us for various reasons. You know better where they are and what they are going through. In whatever circumstances they find themselves, visit with them and remind them of your love. Guide us, O Lord, we ask all this. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Now it's time for our silent prayer. We know what we bring in our hearts, we know what we want to ask from our God, but above all, we take this time to ask for forgiveness for whatever we may have done that did not please our Lord. Let us bow our heads and present ourselves to the Lord. Then we'll follow the morning prayer and the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Father Almighty, you have made us in your image, and you have loved us from the beginning of creation to our days. You continue showing your steadfast love. We bow before you in penitence, asking for forgiveness of our sins. We know we are not perfect. Though we seek perfection, we know it is hard, it's difficult for us to get it because of our human nature. We are distracted by things of this world. For all those things we have done when we're not supposed to do, we say, Father, forgive us. And all the things we have failed to do, Father, forgive us. Grant us that we receive your grace, receive your love. As we are here to worship you, as we present ourselves to you, we know there are brothers and sisters who are hurting. We ask you to give them the comfort they need. Those who are sick, at home, at hospital, we say, Father, have mercy and stretch your healing hand and touch them so that they may receive the cure that comes from you. Those who are mourning the loss of their relatives, we bring them to you. We bring glory and family for the loss of their beloved one, their brother, their son, their uncle. You know how devastating it is for the family to have to go through such kind of tragedy. We say, Father, have mercy on the family and give them the comfort they need. Remind them that you will always stay with them. You will embrace them and you will give them the strength they need. There are so many families going through the same experience. We say, Father, be with them and show your love to them. Once again, bless our congregation, bless our families, bless our country. We say, thank you, Lord. We see a light, a green light before us when it comes to COVID-19. Things seem to be improving each day. And we ask you, Lord, to continue showing your love, continue responding. Our hope is that one day we'll be able to meet in this place without having to wear masks, without having to fear one another, without having to social distance. We hope that will happen soon. And we believe it will happen because we trust in a living God, a caring Father. Hear our prayers, O Father. Heal the world. Heal the world. And we ask all this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as we all pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Bon dia. Bon dia, yes. It is bon dia. It's beautiful out there. I said it last Sunday, if there was a way for me to bribe God to keep the weather like this, honestly, I would do it. I'll do it. Because it looks good and beautiful. Yes, it is so exciting and good to see all of you here. Yes, some of you, I haven't seen you since last year. It's been more than a year since we've been together. And, you know, by God's grace, here we are today. And yes, like Joyce said, we hope one day everyone will come back and will feel safe to be in this place. Well, now it's time for our offerings. But since we're still, you know, this is kind of a soft landing. We are going slowly. We cannot just, cannot rush. Though there is vaccine here and there, but we still have to observe the COVID-19 precautions. So we continue not passing around the plates for offering. And the plates are in the back of the church. If you haven't done your offering, you can still do it at the end or at any time you want. In the meantime, shall we all rise and sing our doxology and present our gifts to the Lord?
Gospel. gospel reading is from the Gospel of John, chapter 2, verses 13 through 22. The Passover of the Jews was near, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple, he found people selling cattle, sheep, and doves, and the money changers seated at their tables. Making a whip of cords, he drove all of them out of the temple, both the sheep and the cattle. He also poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. He told those who were selling the doves, "Take these things out of here. Stop making my Father's house a marketplace." His disciples remembered that it was written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." The Jews then said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews then said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and will you raise it up in 3 days?" But he was speaking of the temple of his body. After he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word that Jesus had spoken. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
We may be seated. Welcome to the third Sunday in Lent. It is always good to be here, and especially when the Lord allows me to stand and share His word with all of you. It is a blessing to me. Today, we read from John chapter 2, verses 13 through 22. Although this story, the story we have just heard about Jesus heading to Jerusalem and visiting the temple, this story is told in all the Gospels. However, unlike the Synoptic Gospels, John brings this story at the beginning of Jesus' ministry. He talks about Jesus going to Jerusalem, having Passover at the beginning of his ministry. This is the second chapter of John. And if you look at the first verses of this chapter, John talks about Jesus starting his ministry by converting water into wine at the wedding of Cana of Galilee. While the Synoptic Gospels talk about this event, they tell this event towards the end of Jesus' ministry. And probably that's what, you know, triggered the anger, and it provoked the chief priests and the scribes to plot against him, to plot to kill him, because of what he says during this visit. For those who have traveled to countries like Mozambique, countries which are called poor countries or developing countries, others also still call them underdeveloped countries, you will not start in the main cities. You find a lot of street vendors. They sell all kind of articles on the streets. They create their own markets, and those markets, they're informal markets. While there are shops, different kind of stores, there are those who prefer to sit on the sidewalks, and they are selling their articles, their stuff there. Not long ago, I think it was last week, as we still follow the news from Mozambique, we saw that, you know, the municipality officials of Maputo is the capital city where we come from, they were in a process of, you know, sending all the street vendors away from the streets. They didn't want to, they don't want to see anyone selling on the streets. They are markets, they are shops, they are given places where they can do their business, but they don't go there. They want to be on the streets because it's where they find people, they interact with people. That's their excuse. And you see that the officials, they have no contemplation, don't have any kind of consideration with those people. All they do is just to take their stuff and put in the trucks and take the tables, put in a truck and take them to the police station. Because they are not allowed to sell them. Jesus is entering Jerusalem. He goes to the temple. What he finds in the temple, he finds people selling goods. He finds people selling cattle, finds people selling sheep, selling doves. And there was even a bureau of the exchange. They had an exchange house in the house of the Lord, exchanging currency. That was an informal business, informal commerce they were doing in the house of the Lord. Jesus gets there. And what he does? You know, this story is one, I guess, is the only story where you see Jesus being aggressive against his audience. Because, you know, the scriptures tell us that he made a whip of cords and he used it to send them out, to kick them out in the temple. He kicked them out from the temple, and I believe, you know, God, while watching that, he said, yeah, here we go. That is my son. And he's doing what he's supposed to do. With him, I'm so pleased because he knows what to do when people don't obey. Keep my father's house clean. Keep my father's house clean. And you see, the Jews now, they ask him, show us signs that tells us, it can tell us where this authority comes from. And he says, you know, just destroy this temple and I will rebuild it in 3 days. I said, well, he must be out of his senses. Do you think you can destroy the temple and rebuild in 3 days? Do you know that it took about 46 years to get this temple where it is? And you say, you tell us that we can destroy and you will rebuild in 3 days? Only those who are with Jesus, only those who listen to Jesus, only those who read the scripture can understand what he says. Here, it says only the disciples could refer his speech to the scriptures. They were the only one who understood what he meant. He was talking about his body. He wasn't talking about the building. He was talking about his body. He calls himself the temple of God, the temple of spirit. And this is confirmed by Paul in the first letter to Corinthians, chapter 6, verse 19. When he's teaching about morality and reminds us that we are the temples of the Holy Spirit. We are the temples of the Holy Spirit. Just reaffirming what Jesus had said. Keep my Father's house clean. Considering ourselves the temple of the Spirit, it is time to examine ourselves. What is it that happens in our bodies, in our being, that does not please the Lord? What is it? Where is it so that we can take it out? This body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And then, since only the disciples were able to understand what he was talking about, and he had told them before that one day I will be sold out, I will be killed, and then on the third day I will rise from the dead. Probably they had not yet fully understood what he was talking about. And here we are told, it wasn't until after he died and resurrected, they realized he was talking about himself. Keep my Father's house clean. When he was still doing his ministry on earth, one way he showed that we should listen to God. We should consider ourselves the body of Christ. We should consider ourselves the temple of the Spirit, was through teaching about love. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. He assumes we love ourselves. And as we love ourselves, we will be able to love our neighbors the same way we love ourselves. But the second thing he did was to teach them about sharing. Sitting at the same table. And the night before he was given away, he brought together his disciples and he shared a meal with them to show the love he has for the world. And as he was passing on the elements, was passing on the cup, he told them, this cup, drink from it, because this represents my blood, which he shed for his poured for you, for the forgiveness of sins, not only for your sins, but the sins of the entire world. His love was for the entire world, not just for those who were with him. That's why we inherit this love even today, even nowadays. Keep my Father's house clean. One way of keeping our Father's house clean is through sharing this table which was set before us. We are all invited, as we took that minute of silent prayer, we presented ourselves to the Lord in penitence, asking for forgiveness. Here is the blood. Here is the body of Christ, which he is giving for us, is giving for forgiveness of our sins. We are all invited to partake from it. And we'll be keeping the house of our Father, our Father's house, clean. We'll be purifying ourselves by the power of the Holy Spirit. Again, what is it that is keeping your life compromised? What is it that is putting you away from the Father? What is it that is making the house of our Father unclean? Think about it as you walk down here. Think about it and ask for forgiveness. Try to change whatever you know doesn't fit God's will. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. As a response, shall we all rise and read the affirmation of faith? Then we'll follow the communion liturgy. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heavens and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under the blood of the Father, was crucified, died, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven,
and seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. But from thence he shall come to judge
the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he
who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. On the night in which he gave himself for us, he took the bread, he gave thanks, and he broke it. He gave it to his disciples and said, take it. This is my body, which is given for you. When the supper was over, he took the cup. After giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, take and drink from it. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured for you for the forgiveness of the sins, not only your sins, but the sins of the whole world. And whenever you do it in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
All honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. The table is ready. We are all invited to come and share. This is an open table. So everyone who feels like needs to receive these grapes, come and receive. Continue observing social distancing so families can come together. The body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, which are given to you, receive, eat, and drink, remembering that Christ died for you. The body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, which are given. Body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Christ died for you and me. And we are reminded that we are the temples of the living God. We are the temples of the Spirit. We have to keep our Father's house clean. This morning we are called, we are invited to partake from this table as means to receive forgiveness of our sins. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which are given for you. Receive it. Yes, it's time to surrender our life to Jesus. We surrender all to Him. All our needs, all our challenges, all the problems, all obstacles that we face in our lives. It's time to surrender our lives to Him. Let us surrender our beings to Him. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ and the blood of Christ poured for you and me. Take, eat, and drink, remembering that Christ died for you. Surrender your life to Him. As we surrender our lives to Him, we'll keep our Father's house clean. That does not belong. The body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ given for you. Take it, eat and drink, remembering that Christ died for you and died for me. And He calls us to follow Him. Body and blood of Lord Jesus Christ, which are given for you, take, eat, and drink, remembering that Christ died for you and died for me, for the cleansing of our sins. And He promises us to give us life, not just life, but everlasting life, abundant life. He invites us He gives us always a second chance. Don't let him pass by. Let's cry out, Savior, Savior. Hear my humble cry. After sharing this table, the holy table, it's time now to give thanks to the Lord for this ministry of salvation through his Son, Jesus Christ. And as to respond to his call, shall we all rise and sing our closing hymn, 128, we'll sing the first and last verses. Gracious and loving God, we have been here in this place. When we started this service, we called for the presence of your Holy Spirit. And because you are faithful, we could feel the warmth of your love and your presence among us. You have spoken to us. We have listened to you. Now, all we have to do is just to follow your instructions, is to follow, is to listen to you and do your will. As we go out, the world is there waiting for us to be the light, to be the salt of this earth. Allow us, O Lord, to do your will and bring more disciples to your house. And now as we leave, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you and guide you until we meet again. Amen.